Good afternoon to all of you. In the last class, we discussed about pointers, the relation between pointers and arrays, the relation between pointers and structures, probably more in a theoretical way. Today we will try to see how a two-dimensional array can be actually passed through a function so that it can be processed. That is, in the last class, we learned that the name of the array is a pointer to the array, or the name of the array contains the base address of the array, or if an array is a two-dimensional one, then the name of the array is a pointer to the first row. That means if P is a 5x5 array, then P means it is the address of the first row, then P plus I corresponds to the address of the ith row, then pointer P plus I is the address of the first cell in the ith row. Similarly, pointer of P plus I plus J is the address of the jth cell in the ith row. And again, if you want to find the value, then you will have to use a double pointer, like that is pointer of pointer and so on. So this is what we discussed in the last class. Similarly, we discussed the relation between structures and pointers also. Now, today let us see how a two-dimensional array can be actually passed to a function so that it can be processed. That is, suppose you have a two-dimensional array of size 5 by 5, then it is an integer array, let us assume. An integer array of size 5 by 5 or 5 by 6 or whatsoever it is there in the main program. Now, your job is to read values into this particular array. And then this array is to be passed as a pointer to a function, where the contents of the array will be printed. So it is simply reading the values into an array in the main program, and then printing those values in a function using a function. That means there you have to pass the array. Fine. That is that you have to pass the array means you have to pass the address of the array to the function, where it will be printed. Fine. So let us see how this job can be performed. Now I will show you two different techniques. That is, one technique will be, that is, as I told you earlier, the name of the array is a pointer to the first row as far as a two-dimensional array is concerned. That is, suppose I have an integer array, integer A of 5 by 6. There are 5 rows and 6 columns. This is an integer array of 5 by 6. There are 5 rows and 6 columns. Now, if I get the address of the first row, that is A. A is the address of the first row, as I told you. Please recall it. Please recall the concept. That is, A is the address of the first row. And A plus I is the address of the ith row. Okay. And similarly, pointer A plus I is the address of the first cell in the ith row. And pointer of A plus I plus J, this is the address of the jth cell in the ith row. And if you want to retrieve the value, you'll have to use a double pointer of a plus I plus j. This will give me the value of a I j. Okay. So now a is the address of the first row. And I had told you that a is the address of the first row, and a plus 0 is the address of the first cell in the 0th row. Okay. So that means this a can be treated in two ways. That is, one is as the address of the first row, or the other way, it is the address of the first cell in the first row. In either way, that is, if you pass the address of the first row, how to process it in the function? Similarly, if you pass the address of the first cell in the first row, then how to process in the function? These two cases will be discussed. That is, in one situation, I will be passing the address of the first cell of the first row. I will be passing the address of the first cell of the first row. Okay, in that case, depending upon the data type, the address of each cell can be computed. The address of each cell can be computed. Fine. Similarly, if it is the address of the first row, then also you can compute. So now let us see how these two cases can be handled, taken care of. So initially, I will be passing the address of the first cell in the first row. I will be passing the address of the first cell in the first row, and then let us see how it can be taken care of in the function. So here, the nature of the parameter which you pass to the function also differs. And we have to see how this is done. So let us see. So here you have a main program. You have a main program. And then, let us assume that you have an array, as I told you earlier, integer a of 5 by 6. It's an integer array. Fine. It's an integer array. Okay. Now, we will be reading values to this integer array. That is, 30 values are to be entered into this integer array. Fine. And then those values are to be printed through a function. So, that is the job. So, definitely, I will be requiring a for loop to read values into this array. Okay. And then, definitely, I require a function is to be defined there. That is, a function is to be declared there. Okay. So here, I will be declaring a function also. That is, this is in an integer array. And then I am defining a control variable I, using which I will be operating a for loop, using which I will be entering values into this array. Okay. Now, I have a function also, which is a void function. Void function. And let me call the name of the function as print array. Print array. And here it is, you see, my parameter is an integer pointer. That is, integer pointer. It is the address of a place where an integer value is there. So naturally, it is the address of a cell. It is the address of a cell. Okay. So that, you see, it is integer pointer. It is integer pointer. That means, here I am passing the address of a location where an integer value is there. So naturally, here the type of parameter which I am passing, or the parameter which I am passing here, is the address of the first cell. That is what I am going to pass in the two-dimensional array. I will be passing the address of the first cell of the first row, which will be passing. Now let us see how it can be done. So this is the function. Void function means it will not be returning any value. The function is not returning any value. The job of the function is to print the value which we will be reading here. Okay. We will be entering some values into this array and that value will be printed in the function. Fine. So now you can do some cosmetic work, like, you know, you can give a message to the user, print of enter values to the array, enter values to the array. So these are all some sort of cosmetics work which is not very relevant when we write small programs. Okay, so we have given a message. Now you have to have a loop. That is, yes, since it is a two dimensional array, I can have two control variables. That is, for I is equal to 0, I lesser than 5, I plus plus. And then you have another loop for j is equal to 0, j lesser than 6, j plus plus. And then you can read each values to the array. Okay. Scanf, that is scanf percentage d and aij. Okay. That is, using these two loops, now I am reading values into this two dimensional array. Once the value is entered, now we will be passing the base address of the array. So again, please keep it in mind here. My base address of the array is the address of the first cell of the array. Address of the first cell of the array will be passed. So that means here, after doing this job, we will be calling the function. That function will be, the function is print array. So we will be calling the function as print array. And the parameter is to be passed. What is the parameter here? As far as the parameter is concerned, it is the address of the first cell. Okay, address of the first cell. Therefore, definitely it is and A00. A00 is the first cell of this two dimensional array, and means it is address. Okay, so here we are passing the address of the first cell of the first row as the parameter. Address of the first cell of the first row as the parameter we are passing. Okay, so that is it. So from here, now the control goes to the function. The control goes to the function where this is to be accepted. That is, this address is to be accepted. So this address is nothing but the address of a cell. Fine. So here, that is to be accepted as a pointer. So let us see now how the function will look like. The function will be looking like this: void print array. Void print array. Integer pointer. See, I am writing integer pointer b. So what happens now? Now here b is getting the address of the first cell. So what you should understand is that is here you have this two dimensional array is there. This is the array. A is the two dimensional array and the address of this particular cell, the address of the first cell will be now assigned to b. Or B will be containing the address of the first cell of the first row. Okay. Now, in order to access each cell, you have to keep on adding what? That is, B is to be simply incremented. B is equal to B plus 1. Again, B is equal to B plus 1. Okay. That is, in B, you are getting the address of the first cell. Okay. Now, if I say B is equal to B plus 1, you will get the address of the next cell. Again, B is equal to B plus 1, you will get the address of the next cell, and so on. Even when you reach here, that is 1, 2, 3, here you can see that there are 6 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, if I do B is equal to B plus 1, I will get the address of the next cell. Okay, that means, this we have discussed in the last class. That is, this is basically the two-dimensional look. The two-dimensional look of an array is absolutely mathematical. It is absolutely logic. According to the programmer, when you define the array, it looks two-dimensional. It is your mathematical model. It is your logical model. But when the memory is allocated, it will be continuous. That means, but through this definition, what we are doing is, you are allocating 30 locations. You have 30 locations where integer values can be stored. That is 5 into 6. Okay? You are storing, you are declaring, through declaring this one, you are allocating 16 locations where integer values can be stored. So that is what is happening. So this is your mathematical model. Okay, in logical model, what will be? There are 30 locations contiguous. There are 30 contiguous locations where integer values can be, it is allocated. Now what will you do? Once you get the address of the first location, you have to simply keep on adding. Okay. So here in D, you are getting the address of the first cell. Now in the program, what is to be done? In the program, what you are supposed to do is, it's a very simple thing now. How many cells are there? That is, the dimension of the array is 5 by 6, therefore there are 30 elements. Therefore, here you should have a loop which will work for 30 times. That's all. That is, for I is equal to, that is, you can have an integer variable here, integer I. Okay? For I is equal to 0, I lesser than or equal to 30, I plus plus. Okay. Now what we have to do? Print of percentage D, pointer A plus I. That's all. This is the only thing which you have to do. So here, pointer B plus I, because the variable which we have used is B. Pointer B plus I. So in B, basically what you are doing? In B, you have got the address of the first cell. And here when I is equal to 0, B plus 0 is B. B is the address of the first cell and pointer B will give you the content of that particular cell. Then B plus 1, that address will be incremented by how many units? Address will be incremented by 2 units. Okay, because B is containing the address of a location where an integer is there. And for an integer, you require 2 bytes of memory. Therefore, B plus Y will always increase the contents of it by 2 units. Okay, that means, suppose you need the initial value of B is 100. Then 100 plus 1 will be 102. Then again 102 plus 1 will become 104. That is the address of the third cell. And so on. So here, basically, here you are printing the contents of the array as if it is single dimension. That is, yes, it is actually the allocation of the memory is definitely single dimensional. Right? The other one is absolutely mathematical, that is logical or programmer's view, but actually in the memory, always memory is allocated contiguously or sequentially. So this is one way of passing the parameter, you see. That is, here I am passing the address of the first cell, address of the first cell. So that is why it is an integer pointer. And here this variable is getting the value. Now let us see how the address of the first row can be passed. Address of the first row. What is the difference? And what will happen to that? Okay. So here, if you want to pass the address of the first row, here there will be a slight change. In this, the type of the parameter which you pass, you have to define like this. That is, integer, fine. You take any variable. You can take any variable here. That will be A, and then define like this. Put two brackets. Two square brackets. This means I am passing, in this situation, that is, I will be passing the address of a row of a two-dimensional. And if you want, you can even give the size of the array, that will also that also will not give you any error. That is, you have to put these two brackets. That is, this is a pointer. That is, when I write like this, it is a point. It's a point. Okay. So that means here, in the, through this, what we are informing the compiler, what we are intimating, educating the compiler is that you are going to pass the address of a row. You are going to be address of a row of a two-dimensional. Okay. Now, so here at the receiving place also, that is at the function also, there is a slight difference. That is because here you are passing Z. That is, you see, the address of the first cell of the first row and the address of the first row, even though the value is same, the nature is different. Okay. Suppose 100 is the address of the first cell of the first row, then 100 is the address of the first row also. But if you treat it as a row, then 100 plus 1 will give me the address of the second row. That is, the quantity by which it will get incremented is different if you treat it as the address of the first row. Whereas if you treat that is the type, if you consider it as the address of the first cell in the first row, then 100 plus 1 will give me the address of the next cell. So that we should, that the function should know. That is here, if I do not change this, here there will be a mismatch. Because here, this B can only contain the address of a cell. So it cannot contain the address of a row. Therefore, accordingly, I have to change it. Okay. So here, also you define, that is, this is to be slightly changed. Integer B, you define like this. Put two brackets. Okay. Put two brackets. That means, here, you are passing the address of a row and here you are receiving address of the, okay. Now, what you can do, you can have two loops, okay, rather than a single loop, you can have two loops here, that is integer i and j. Integer I and j, and then same thing for I is equal to whatever be, the same loop can be used for I is equal to 0, I less than I plus plus. For j equal to 0, j less than 6, you have same two loops and then printing can be performed. Okay. And here if you want, you can put the size of the array also, 5, 6 and here 5, 6, then also there will be no problem. It will work. Okay. That means here in the second situation, the nature of the data which we are passing is the address of the row. Whereas in the previous case, it was the address of the first cell in the first row. In both the case, so both can be taken care of. You can do in either way. Fine? There is no difference because ultimately the data stored in the memory is continuous. It is sequential. Okay? So for all practical purposes, all the cells will be contiguous in the memory. Fine? So address calculation can be done straight away. There is no, absolutely no problem. Now, so knowing all this, let us go to the next step ahead, one more step ahead. So now you know the relation between pointers and arrays, you know the relation between pointers and structures,